What's up, everybody? Hello, hello. So we got a lot on the agenda today, going over AKS today, or Azure's Kubernetes Service. So what we need to do first and foremost is we need to refactor our environments. Basically, what we need to do is we need to get rid of anything that we don't need and keep what we do need. We need to go into our Terraform, and we actually need to essentially go to feature. No, we'll just call it a feature, whatever, because it's on a feature thing. So we'll just do that. It's going to go off the main branch, and I'm going to hit create branch Terraform here, and I'm going to do git checkout main full fetch git branch A, okay, branch D, cool. Okay, and then we do git checkout dash B feature slash refactor resources. Okay, as a matter of fact, what I'm gonna do for now is I'm actually gonna get rid of like all the stuff we don't need. We're just gonna start essentially from the ground up. All right, so let's take a look at our diffs here. So we got rid of that. We don't need anything related to container instances anymore. We got rid of the main for the cache name and the container instance as well. We got rid of the network profile for the container instance. We got rid of the Redis private DNS zone and its network link, as well as the private endpoint for Redis 2. We got rid of the actual cache instance. We're not even going to be paying for that anymore. We got rid of the resource groups for cache and container. Service principles gone bye-bye. And the subnet as well is also removed. I'm going to go here. I'm going to click on this, and I'm just going to sign it to myself. We're going to go here, flip that, go here, and we're going to create a pull request with that task. Work items, refactor environments, see how far this has gone. Are we both good on this? Yep, we are. Okay, we're going to go back here. So what's going to happen? So it's going to destroy the private endpoint, and then it's going to update the subnet accordingly to the new dressing, which we want. Public IP spot node pool. So this is really what we want right here. So if you guys have ever used Amazon before, you probably know about spot instances. They save you a lot of money. Basically, you can do the same thing with Azure, which is pretty awesome. So we'll expand this really quickly. Take a look. Private endpoint gets destroyed, and so does the subnet for it too. Awesome. So let's go ahead and approve. Refresh, just so I make sure. Cool. And complete. And then we will complete this work item. Alrighty. So now, again, I'm going to go back to Terraform Cloud. All right, we're going to grab this one, actually, for now. We're just going to use the one right here for now so that I can, like, look at both of them. Boom. Look at that. Two destroyed. Perfect. All right. So the subnet. All right, cool. So that all of that applied. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to here and prod, and I'm going to actually run the same thing here, except for we're going to run this one. So we're going to discard, and we're going to run that. Okay. Okay, cool. So it's going to destroy 15 and change 1. There we go. And let's let that run as well. So let's go ahead and do git checkout. Just go ahead and delete that branch really quickly. Yep. And then I'm going to create a new branch. This one is going to be for provisioning the AKS cluster. So I'm going to click create branch. I'm going to say feature AKS cluster. I'm going to copy that really quickly so I don't have to type it later. And there we go. So we'll go back here. I'm going to delete that. And I'm going to paste that in its place. And there we go. So now if I go here, let's look at what we got. So we've got our virtual network. That's good. Our TwinGate access token and refresh tokens, we're still going to need those, but we're not going to worry about them right now. So the subnet, that's going to be something we need. So let's go ahead and take a look at the Kubernetes examples. And we should see nodes on the internal network. See that? The internal pool sits on that. So we need to make sure that that is also the case. And so we're going to just basically copy this, and this will be our second subnet now. So now we only have two subnets, chat. So let's go network topology. We can get rid of this, get rid of this. All of this can go away. This can go away. This can go away. Even this can go away. Key vault can go away. So we're going to copy and paste, and we're going to create a new network. And this is going to be Kubernetes. So this is going to be our Quirk Dev Kubernetes. And we're going to go in here, and we're going to say Kubernetes. Cool. Kubernetes services. So what'll happen now is these will just go directly out over this subnet and access the database like so. A lot more straightforward in the sense of the networking. We literally have two subnets, database and Kubernetes, and they just talk to each other one over the other. So this is all fine. This is good. I just need to create a new one for the Kubers. All right, so we're going to do that. Paste that in. Delete both of those and then do Kubernetes. Look at that. Thank you. All right. So now we've got our resource group and our subnet for Kubernetes. So let me just go over here. Okay, cool. Kubernetes. I'm going to just go ahead and add this stuff. So database name is good. Kubernetes is good. Subnet addresses is good. That's good. Kubernetes name, virtual network self, Kubernetes. Cool. Okay, cool. And so now I'm going to do feature Kubernetes. So this is going to add the resource group and the networking. Let's just make sure that this runs. Hey, look at that, chat. And everything got deleted properly. So now if I go into Azure and I refresh, we should see a lot of those resources disappear. Yep. Look at that. Remember how I just had like container instances and all that stuff here? All of that's gone. So if we go to container instances, should be gone. Yep. Completely gone. Cool. Okay. So we have officially cleaned and refactored the environment. So we added this and we added this Yeah, all this looks good. Okay, we've got the nodes on the internal network. We've got the private API server so that we know it's only accessible internally. We made sure we've got our network policy with Calico. Yeah, I think those are the basics of what we need. I'm going to add the Kubernetes cluster and I'm going to add the outputs. Push, and let's see if it works in Terraform. All right, so let's take a look here. So Kubernetes cluster, okay. Sensitive value, raw config, raw, SUS dev, SKU tier free. That's good. I like that. I like seeing free. No ACI, none of that. Autoscaler, not worrying about any of that right now. Network profile, standard, Calico, load balancer. All right, yeah, this looks good. And then we'll get the client secrets and the kubeconfig afterwards. Okay, I think that looks good. Okay, so let's go back here. Look at this run really quickly. Just make sure that it's all good. And again, I'm going to actually move out of this now. I'm going to close this. Dev Kubernetes, good, looks good. Cool, okay, awesome. So we should have a new plan here. Planned. Fix Kubernetes. Yep, there we go. Fix its resource group. Confirm and apply. All right. So let's see if this gives us our Kubernetes cluster. All right. So we should see the subnet actually get created pretty quickly. I'm going to go here. Go to subnets. Yep, there it is. It's already been created. All right. We got this, chat. We got this. Come on. We can do it. I think it's actually provisioning now. Normally it like kicks back. Yep, there it is. Yes. Okay. Woo! All right, we're good. Sorry, I just got really excited. Okay, cool. So yeah, dude, there it is. So here's our Kubernetes cluster. It's still being created by what's it called? So if I click on it, you're actually going to see that it says creating still. But you can see here, we've got like our Kubernetes encryption type. We don't have any node pools yet, or we're not doing any virtual node pools with ACI. So that's been disabled. You can see we've got one node pool running 127 on the standard B2S. We've got Kubernetes version itself, which is on the same. We don't have RBAC enabled right now, or AKS, Active Directory, Azure CNI, Pod Cider, Service Cider, DNS IP, Docker Cider, Calico, Load Balancer. All of this looks good. Cool, we have a Kubernetes cluster. If you wanna create a Kubernetes cluster like I did, all you have to do is first and foremost, create yourself a resource group. Boom, right here, we can see our new resource group, our new Kubernetes resource group. After we created our resource group, we then created our subnet. Now, again, I have some nice little magic sauce around how I dynamically generate my subnets address prefixes, but at the end of the day, it's basically a CIDR for that network, or for that subnet, sorry. So here's our subnet. And then after we created our subnet, we went ahead and created our Kubernetes cluster. And so we gave it the name, we gave it the resource group information, we gave it the DNS prefix, made sure that it was private. This is a, you know, $100 cluster. It's running the burst SKU. We made sure that we set up the network profile to be Azure. The load balancer is the standard SKU because it did seem to make more sense for the options we got out of it. We also got Calico as our networking policy. Once we did that, we ran Terraform. You can see here it is right here. Here's our outputs. Now I'm not going to click that because if I click that, you'll see it. But you'll see here that my apply has successfully finished the first time, chat. The first time, chat. That's pretty dope. And now I have a Kubernetes cluster fully running in Azure. So yeah, there you go. That is it. First try too, chat. Pretty dope.